Guys, Jay Hoyt here. Before this video gets started, we've been reminding you guys for the longest time. The vast majority of you guys are not even subscribed. So if you haven't yet, or if you're brand new here, make sure to go down below, hit that subscribe button, turn on those post notifications so you never miss an upload. And don't forget, you can always change your mind later. Guys, Jay Hoyt back with you today. Welcome back to Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. We got some league play for you in the background, playing some Hardpoint on Garrison. So as always, I hope you guys do enjoy that. But we got a pretty interesting topic, right? We've seen throughout the entirety of the CDL, and especially this year, the Optic Chicago, right? This is the team that I support, right? I've supported these guys since, what, Call of Duty Ghosts, like, or I should say the like end of Call of Duty Ghosts, and I've been following them forever, right? So I support them, I've been watching them all through the years, but just whatever reason this year, they're a good team, but not necessarily a great team. So, you know, obviously there's 1.5 million people trying to figure out what, you know, Optic should do to fix themselves, right? They're always in consideration for being one of the best teams, and they got the talent, right? The names are there on paper, but for whatever reason, the last little bit here, you know, they just haven't been performing and they haven't really, you know, made it to that top tier status just yet. But with the new talents in the scene with FaZe and Toronto and Dallas and even New York, you know, those kind of are the top five teams in the game right now. And, you know, once Optic ran the scene, right, they won almost everything. And they were always in consideration. They might have had, you know, a quote-unquote bad tournament when they placed second or, you know, lost in the grand finals. But now you got Simp, Abizi, Selium, and Arcides over on the FaZe side. You got some new talent, some new young talent. And, you know, they've kind of taken over. And, you know, Optic has always been, like I said, the biggest organization, the most watched organization. And now they got to do something, right? I mean, Scump and Formal aren't getting any younger. You know, they tried to pick up some young guns to, you know, put on the side of them. And this team isn't working. So, like I said earlier, this team is good. They're really good, but they're not great, right? FaZe in Toronto, Dallas, New York are just ahead of them, right? It's just, it's hard, but it's true. So what do these guys do? So let's identify the problems, right? This team has four players that all have very unique play styles. And, you know, you have Formal, who's always been a really good Slayer. You have Dashy, who's a very good young player that has always been a Slayer. You have Envoy, who's kind of like the dirty work, you know, route player that likes to flank and, you know, still, you know, puts up the kills and puts up, you know, the numbers, but sometimes doesn't at the same time. And you have Scump, who's always been considered as a really good Slayer, but he's also a very good pre-aim player, if you know what that means. So when you ADS or, you know, aim down your sight, right, that's where he kind of excels, and he plays pretty well. But for whatever reason, this team just doesn't work together. So we're going to create a very hypothetical situation that Scump and Formal both retire. Now, do I think that's going to happen? No, right? I still think they got, you know, a couple of years left. And, you know, if they want to play at that point, they'll be, you know, later 20s, and maybe they want to move on to just content or, you know, just focus on content, because both of those players have a big enough brand individually that Scump could go on, stream Warzone, even play just not competitive COD, but just make Call of Duty content or basically do whatever he wants to, you know, be in the COD scene because he's such a big name talent. Does he go on to like an ownership or, you know, invest in Optic himself and kind of go off and do his own thing? Who knows what they would do? I mean, Formal kind of the same thing. You know, they've been around the Optic brand long enough. They've won with Optic. They're huge names in Optic history. They would definitely stay with the Optic brand somehow. Obviously, Scump and Formal not hurting for money. You know, Scump, you know, is a co-owner of what is, I don't remember what it is. Is it drink control or something like that? He co-owns with like Sensor and like I think a couple other players and maybe some other people. Don't know too much about it, but you know, he obviously is trying to do well for himself, and he also admits he doesn't really spend a lot of money, so he's got to be working on that, you know, behind the scenes. But that leaves Optic, right? What do they do? So in that hypothetical situation when Scump and Formal both retire, right? Just picture in your head, they both retire, right? Now you have Envoy and you have Dashy that'd be looking for two, you know, if those two wanted to stay together, that is. So we're going to play with if Envoy and Dashy stay together as a team of two, looking for two on Optic, right? So we look at Formal's, you know, position, right? He's a main AR, an AR player. Who do you replace him with? Now, everyone would probably say Octane, right? A big name in the Call of Duty community, a very good player in his own right, and already does content. So he would mesh in with the Optic brand perfectly, right? He would step into that role, you know, would give him a chance to get off Seattle and, you know, get out of that horrible situation. He'd come into an Optic, you know, brand that he was part of before, didn't really end too great, but still, you know, we'd have a really solid, good top tier AR in that spot, plus a guy that already does content, so it would mesh pretty well. I mean, Sam, you know, Octane himself, you know, I do kind of enjoy watching his content. I wish I could see some more gameplay from him, just to, you know, learn more about how he plays and everything, but he'd probably be the number one option. But then you also have guys like Skies, who's on Florida, but they also, you know, are pretty high on him, but he struggles with, you know, consistency issues, and who knows how much that would actually work out. Then you have one of their own roster guys in general, who's, like I said, already on the roster. You know, would they want to put him into the mix? I mean, he's still somewhat young, but they might want to go after someone else. Maybe does he move on to some other team? What would they do with General in that case, right? Because he's an AR player, and I'm not sure, you know, what exact role he plays, if he could play a flex or if he would be that main AR role. But he's also a guy that wouldn't necessarily have to be the spotlight player, right? If you have Dashy slaying around, you had Envoy slaying and doing his thing, and then eventually we'll talk about, you know, if Scump does retire, his replacements. But does General fit in that role, right? Someone that, you know, doesn't have to be a superstar in order to be on this starting roster. And that could be what they need. I'm not exactly sure. But then you move on to some guys that more run the actual true flex role. Guys like Mac from the New York Subliners. But given their recent success, are they going to want to get rid of him? You know, probably not. But just an option there. Sell, I don't think this is talking about Sell Yum. I think this is talking about Sell, a guy in the Challenger scene, but has been, you know, a pretty good, I guess, prospect, if you will, in the last little bit. So do they want to give a guy in, you know, from Challengers a good chance at being in the Pro League? You know, probably be a pretty good idea. Then you have Awakening from Florida as well. So him and Skies, our teammates right now, so he's been performing pretty well. But the only reason I wouldn't think Awakening would be a good fit is because he's kind of reserved, right? He doesn't really do content. He's kind of, you know, more laid back, you know, doesn't really express his personality too much. Now, could they try to get it out of him? Could they try to, you know, shape him into be, you know, a good part of that team? Most definitely, right? He's definitely got the talent. He's definitely got you know, the scene behind him, if you will, that he could probably make a pretty good a fit on that team as a flex role. And he's been an absolute beast since he debuted. What was it, last year or this year, whatever it was? And, you know, he's been a huge force. Other guys, you have Draza, who's kind of been in and out of the lineup in the last couple of years for Optic Gaming Los Angeles, you know, before, you know, I should say Fake Optic. And then you had him over on the LA Thieves side when they put him in and out a couple of times now. And has shown that he can be a top player and perform really well for that team. But, you know, does LA Thieves want to get rid of him? Obviously, depending on what they're going to do with their squad. They got a few different players that we'll talk about here. And then you have guys like Priesta over from the Minnesota Rocker side. Could be a decent option. I don't know too much about him, but definitely could be an interesting option. Then you have Gravity. Don't know too much about him either, but another Challengers player that, you know, all these guys could fit into that role. You know, like I said, do I think any of those players will, or, you know, what would be like the number one option? I'd either go Octane or maybe like a Draz or even like a Priesta, right? Those would kind of be my top three. I think some of those other guys could be decent options, but I think if they're going to try to win now and, you know, win with this next roster, that they'd want to get, you know, one of those three guys. So let's move on to Skump though, right? If Skump retires, what players would, you know, benefit the team most in this situation? You have guys like Standy, but also he's on Minnesota, and they seem to be pretty high on him as he looks to be one of their best players. So maybe unlikely that they get him. Another player, similar situation, is Neptune from Florida. There's a couple guys from Florida here, but Neptune, he's been really good in search, but, you know, does that fit well? Who knows? Then we have Hook. He's been kind of dealing with his own problems as it is. So would he fit onto this squad? I don't know, right? You'd have to kind of trial him and see how he plays with Envoy, but they also kind of play a similar role. Then you have another guy like TJ Haley, who's been on Optic before, was over on the fake Optic side as well, and probably will be a free agent after this year. So he could be a potential pickup. Then you have guys like Asim and Shotzi, both on top teams. Asim with New York, Shotzi with Dallas. Obviously, both those teams are top teams. Would they want to give either of those players up? Probably not, but lots of options there. Who would be the best fit? I mean, they'd almost have to trial out a lot of these players just to see who fits well, who meshes well, and who they see most potential in. And obviously, there's a lot of players, you know, looking for spots in the CDL. But here's also the big question, right? What if they don't retire, right? Skump and Formal most likely will decide when they're done playing. And which almost means they're basically undroppable, which means most likely they can't get dropped. So where does that leave us? That leaves us Dashing Envoy. Again, both disgusting players. They both have a unique play style. You know, what would be the fix for this team, right? Either someone's got to adjust their play style or kind of take a hit and play a role that maybe they're not necessarily too comfortable in, or, you know, exactly what the case would be. But let's kind of break it down player by player, right? If Formal is gone, right, just him, and they want to replace just him, does Dashy then move to the main AR role and they pick up a true flex, a guy that can play both an SMG and a sub role? You know, who fits in that role? I mean, Priesta, I mean, if you could pick up a guy like Octane or Skies, those guys are main ARs, so you're kind of in a similar spot as you are now. If Skump's gone, we kind of already, you know, mentioned who would possibly replace him. But who fits well next to Envoy, right? That's where it'd have to be. You know, you'd have to do your research. You'd have to talk to these guys. And again, maybe even trial them. Then you also have if Envoy's gone, right? If you want to get rid of the Prince, if you want to call him that, does TJ Haley come back in? Right, I know they were talking, he made it, I think it was a tweet or a reply or something. He said, yeah, the worst mistake of his career was leaving Skump. So, you know, maybe does he replace him as a one-for-one change? I mean, Envoy would then move on to some other organization, most likely, because he most likely wouldn't want to be, you know, a reserve or a Challengers player or anything. And, you know, picking up TJ from LA Thieves probably wouldn't be a, you know, terribly difficult acquisition, especially given, obviously, the long history between Nadeshot and Optic and, obviously, Hex himself. But who would fit next to him? I mean, that'd be kind of difficult, but who would fit next to Skump as well? Again, I'm not too sure. Then you look at Dashy, though. Who would be a good fit there? I mean, do you go for a true flex? You know, a Priesta or an Awakening or like a half these guys would be an option in there. But the big discussion is they need to do something, right? There's lots of options there. You know, they can add to their coaching staff to try to help, right? Karma's there, but, you know, how involved is he actually? Because I've never, you know, really seen him, you know, at the Hex quarters or, you know, watching scrims. So how involved is he? Obviously, he's a world champion, a three-time world champion, and could definitely help this team tremendously. So what do they do? I think they should add to their coaching staff, right? Whether it's Karma as a serious role, or they get someone, right? There's lots of big name players out there that could definitely fit into a coaching role really well. Obviously, lots of guys that have won before and potentially guys that, you know, aren't the best players but could definitely help this team. I think they should add their coaching staff. You know, if they don't want to make a roster change, you know, and switch up this this four players, then someone needs to adjust something with their play style. I think Dashi and Envoy would have to probably be the first two that would, just because of how you know, how long Scump and Formal have been playing, that they need to do something different. You know, how hard would that be? Especially if they're young, they should be able to adapt a little bit easier. And like I said, something needs to change. But what is it? I don't know. Obviously, I don't want any of these players to retire or move on from this squad. But if they want to take this team to the next level, if they want to be considered, you know, in the tier one teams right now, because they realistically are fifth in the power rankings, right? Behind Atlanta, Toronto, Dallas, and New York, you know, they are struggling. And what it's going to take, I'm not sure. What I hope they do, like I said, I don't want anyone to leave this team. But if somebody has to, I don't know even know how you'd begin to try to figure that out. I mean, obviously, that'd be some internal discussions. I think they'll probably wait until after this year to do anything and move on to next year. But hopefully they figure it out relatively soon, because I'd like to see Optic win a tournament and, you know, obviously do super well at Champs, you know, to give me something else to root for. Because it's always tough, you know, doing predictions and you're like, well, they're good, but they're not great. But then also kind of hurt your heart as in a fan of the team that, you know, you're predicting them to lose. So it's a tough situation. I hope they figure it out really soon. But I'd love to hear all of your thoughts and comments down there in that comment section. But that's where I'm going to wrap it up for today. Like I said, leave your thoughts down below. I'd love to, you know, hear you guys' thoughts on it. What should they do? Do they replace a player? How many players do they get rid of or, you know, trade or acquire or whatever word you want to use? Who do they pick up? Why? Where do they fit into the squad? Let me know all that down in the comment section below. But as always, guys, if you did enjoy, hit that like button down below if you haven't yet. Or if you're brand new here, make sure to subscribe. Turn those post notifications on so you never miss an upload. And don't forget, you can always change your mind later. But as always, guys, we'll see you in the next one. In the shadow.